Our story begins with our early human ancestors, who likely had darker skin due to the intense sun exposure of Africa. As some of these populations ventured out and migrated to Europe, they encountered a new environment, one with less ultraviolet radiation. This shift in the sun's exposure sets the stage for an intriguing evolutionary question. When did light skin appear in humans? Join us as we unlock the science of skin color and unravel the intriguing adaptation of our ancestors from across the globe. People living near the equator, where the sun is strong, often have darker skin in contrast to people living further north, who tend to have lighter skin tones. The incredible variety of shades of color we humans have acquired through thousands of generations is comparable to a living rainbow. Let's find out what exactly causes this fascinating difference. Scientific genes, like the ones with the tongue-twister names SLC24A5 and SLC45A2, influence how much melanin we produce. The difference in our skin tones is controlled by these genes, which hold the instructions for building melanin, a pigment that acts like natural coloring for our skin. You can think of it as the volume control of your skin color. Here's where things get interesting. Where your earliest ancestors come from plays a big role. It's a story passed down through generations using our genes. Populations around the world have adapted to different amounts of sunshine through time. Folate, a crucial vitamin for reproduction, is broken down by strong sun exposure. It is essential for healthy cell division, which is vital for fetal development during pregnancy. Strong sunlight can damage folate in the body. In places with intense sunlight, like near the equator, people naturally have more melanin. This melanin acts like a shield, protecting folate to promote healthy reproduction. That's why we often see darker skin tones in these regions. Higher levels of melanin is an adaptation that keeps folate levels healthy for reproduction. Let's take a closer look at the different types of melanin that create this amazing spectrum of human skins. In a way, melanin acts as a natural paintbrush for our skin, but there is more than one shade in an artist's palette. That's right, melanin comes in two main types, called eumelanin and pheomelanin. Eumelanin can be referred to as the dark-toned brother. It's like a deep brown paint, giving skin a richer color and more protection from the sun. Pheomelanin, on the other hand, is the lighter, reddish-brown cousin of melanin. It adds a touch of warmth to the skin tones. The ratio of these pigments is the real reason behind our skin color. More eumelanin means a darker shade, and if the ratio of pheomelanin is higher, it means lighter tones. What's even more interesting is the fact that this ratio also has a geographical twist. Remember how we mentioned sun exposure affecting melanin production? Places closer to the equator, where the sun beats down strong, naturally have more eumelanin for protection. That's why darker skin tones are more common in these regions. As we move further north, with less intense sunlight, pheomelanin tends to play a bigger role, resulting in lighter skin tones. If we were to imagine a world map with a heat overlay showing solar radiation intensity, it would be the strongest near the equator and gradually decreasing near the poles. Now, if you were to have another layer on the same map, this time showing skin color distribution, you will see that darker skin tones are where the solar radiation intensity is the strongest, and vice versa. So people near the Arctic region, with even less sunlight, should have the lightest skin, right? Actually, let's find out why that may not be the case. And if you find this video interesting, subscribe to support our channel and join us on the amazing journey of human evolution. There seems to be a bit of a paradox when it comes to the Arctic population. Despite low UV light, they don't necessarily have very light skin. Unlike populations closer to the equator, who relied heavily on sun exposure for vitamin D, traditional Arctic communities thrived on a diet consisting of fish and whale blubber. These were packed with vitamin D. This dietary adaptation brilliantly compensated for the lack of sunshine, ensuring significant vitamin D levels even within lighter skin tones. Some scientists believe that the Arctic populations may have developed genetic adaptations for vitamin D metabolism. Their bodies may be more efficient in using the limited vitamin D available. Humans have not inhabited the Arctic regions for as long as some other parts of the world. Skin lightening is a gradual evolutionary adaptation. It may well be possible that there hasn't yet been enough time for significant lightening to occur in these populations. We can assume that the lack of light skin in the Arctic isn't a flaw in the system. It's a fascinating story of adaptation. Their darker tones might offer other benefits in the harsh Arctic environment, while their diet and potential genetic adaptations ensure they get the vitamin D they need. So, how long did it take for our ancestors to develop light skin after coming to Europe or other low UV light places? We might assume the change happened quickly, like a chameleon adapting to its surroundings, but the truth is far more intriguing. Genetic evidence suggests a fascinating timeline. While our ancestors may have arrived in Europe much earlier, their genes associated with lighter skin appear to have become widespread only around 22,000 to 28,000 years ago during the time of the Upper Paleolithic. So, what might explain this delay in light skin development? Remember, our darker skins offer protection against UV radiation, which can damage folate, a vital B vitamin for reproduction. In Africa's high sun environment, this protection was crucial. However, in Europe's lower UV setting, the need for such strong protection might have lessened. This leads us to a new question: vitamin D. Unlike folate, a B vitamin that we primarily get in food, our bodies can actually synthesize vitamin D from sunlight exposure. So while darker skin protected folate in Africa, it also limited vitamin D production. In Europe, with less sun, lighter skin might have offered an advantage by allowing for better vitamin D synthesis. This leads us to think that the twist could lie in our diet. Did our ancestors have a readily available source of vitamin D to compensate for the reduced sun exposure? While the specifics of our ancestors' diet are still being explored, it is entirely possible that early Europeans may not have had a diet as rich in vitamin D as some populations closer to the equator with abundant fish sources. This lack of dietary alternative to sun-produced vitamin D could explain why the development of lighter skin, which would aid vitamin D synthesis, took a significant amount of time. As lighter skin offered a survival advantage in the lower UV environments by promoting vitamin D, those with these genes would have had a higher chance of passing them on to future generations. Over thousands of years, this gradual selection process led to the lighter skin tones we see in many Europeans today. So were the first Europeans white-skinned? The term white is actually quite broad, encompassing a wide range of light skin tones. While some early Europeans likely had light skin compared to their African ancestors due to the evolutionary advantages we discussed, like better vitamin D synthesis in a lower UV environment, it is important to remember that skin color is a spectrum. Think of it like a gradient, with very dark tones on one end and very light tones on the other. Early Europeans probably fell somewhere in the middle of the spectrum, with a range of light skin tones emerging over time. So we could say they occupied a sweet spot in that spectrum. This would not have necessarily resembled the stereotypical image of white that dominates our modern perception. Think of historical paintings from Europe. The people depicted show a stunning variety of complexions, a testament to the rich tapestry of human diversity throughout history, one that is shaped by various factors, like their initial skin tones upon arrival, the unique ecological niches they inhabited within Europe, and the specific migration routes of different groups. So, if you love learning about the evolution of our ancestors, check out our other videos on the various species that make up our puzzling lineage. The evolution of skin color is indeed a fascinating tale of adaptation.